Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Biochemistry Concepts. This video is about heme synthesis. In this, first we will see what are the materials required for the heme synthesis. Then we will see about the actual pathway of heme synthesis. Heme synthesis starts with two simple precursors. One is glycine and the second one is succinyl-CoA. The two major sites of heme synthesis are RBC precursors and liver. Coming to the subcellular site, within the cell, heme synthesis takes place in cytoplasm and partly in the mitochondria because of distribution of enzymes in the cytoplasm and mitochondria. There are total 8 enzymes which are required for the heme synthesis. So out of these, first enzyme and the last 3 enzymes, they are present in the mitochondria, and the remaining, that is second to fifth enzyme, they are present in the cytosol. The coenzyme required for heme synthesis is PLP, pyridoxal phosphate, in the first reaction. And the other materials like ferrous form of the iron is also required, and that is required in the last step. In the first step of heme synthesis that takes place in the mitochondria, condensation of glycine and succinyl-CoA occurs. So glycine is a non-essential amino acid and succinyl-CoA is intermediate of TCS cycle. Condensation of these two forms a delta aminolevulinic acid. This reaction is catalyzed by ALA synthase, and as we discuss, it requires the coenzyme pyridoxal phosphate. So that's why deficiency of pyridoxin leads to anemia. So PLP is a coenzyme or active form of the pyridoxin. This ALA synthase is a rate limiting enzyme, also called as key enzyme of the heme synthesis. It is also an inducible enzyme. Next reaction is formation of porphobilinogen. So it is formed from ALA. So this takes place in cytosol. So this ALA, which is formed in the mitochondria, diffuses into the cytosol. In this step, two molecules of ALA, delta aminolevulinic acid, they condense to form 4 molecules of porphobilinogen. So this porphobilinogen is a monopyrrole, single pyrrole. This condensation involves the removal of 2 molecules of water. ALA dehydratase catalyzes this reaction, and it contains zinc. For its activity, it requires the zinc. And this ALA dehydratase is inhibited by heavy metal lead. That's why elevation of ALA levels and anemia are observed in lead poisoning. Next step is formation of uroporphyrinogen 3. 4 molecules of porphobilinogen condense to form the first porphyrin of the heme synthetic pathway, that is uroporphyrinogen 3. So in which the 4 pyrrole rings are interconnected by methylene bridges. So these are actually derived from the alpha carbon of glycine. That is, these methylene bridges are derived from alpha carbon of glycine. So actually, this formation involves the successive action of 2 enzymes. The first is uroporphyrinogen 1 synthase, which is also called as porphobilinogen deaminase. And the second one is uroporphyrinogen 3 co-synthase. Uroporphyrinogen 1 synthase catalyzes the condensation of 4 porphobilinogen units to form the linear tetrapyrrole. This linear tetrapyrrole is called as hydroxymethylbilane. During this deamination, 4 molecules of ammonia are removed. And this hydroxymethylbilane is very unstable intermediate, and this undergoes spontaneous cyclization to form uroporphyrinogen 1. Uroporphyrinogen 3 co-synthase rearranges the orientation of propionate and estate side chains on one of the pyrrole rings, that is ring number 4. Due to this rearrangement, it produces the asymmetric physiological type 3 isomer, that is uroporphyrinogen 3. So actually, these porphyrinogens are colorless, but these are readily oxidized to porphyrins, which are colored compounds. So in the next step, coproporphyrinogen 3 is formed, and it is formed from uroporphyrinogen 3 by decarboxylation. This reaction is catalyzed by uroporphyrinogen 3 decarboxylase. This enzyme decarboxylates all 4 estate side chains to methyl groups. So due to this, the total 4 carbon dioxide molecules are eliminated in this reaction. Coproporphyrinogen 3 is formed in cytosol, and this diffuses into the mitochondria. From next step onwards, remaining reactions takes place in the mitochondria. In mitochondria, the coproporphyrinogen 3 is oxidized to protoporphyrinogen 9 by coproporphyrinogen oxidase. This enzyme specifically acts only on type 3 series and not on type 1 series. During this reaction, 2 propionic acid side chains from ring 1 and 2 are oxidatively decarboxylated to vinyl groups. In the next reaction, protoporphyrinogen oxidase oxidizes methylene groups to methanyl groups. This leads to the formation of protoporphyrin 9. And next step is the final step, the final reaction in which heme is formed. So that is synthesis of heme. In this reaction, the ferrous iron is incorporated into the protoporphyrin 9. And this reaction is catalyzed by ferrochelatase or heme synthetase. And this enzyme is inhibited by lead. Some very important points about heme pathway are localization. So it takes place in most mammalian tissues except mature erythrocytes due to lack of mitochondria. Polarity of the intermediates. The initial intermediates of the pathway, they are polar. Uroporphyrinogen is strongly polar since all its side chains are predominantly polar. That is, it contains 4 estate and 4 propionate groups. But the subsequent intermediates are more non-polar. Porphyrinogens versus porphyrins. So the porphyrinogens are reduced porphyrins. They are not colored because their pyrrolings are connected by methylene bridges, and the double bonds are not conjugated over the whole system. The actual intermediates of heme synthesis are porphyrinogens. When these porphyrinogens are exposed to light, they lose hydrogen atoms and are converted to corresponding colored porphyrins. For example, coproporphyrinogen is colorless. So when it loses hydrogens, it is converted to colored coproporphyrin. Same way, uroporphyrinogen is converted to colored uroporphyrins.